the research laboratories of an oil company in Tulsa, the industry on parade cameras find a young boy busy among the test tubes and petri dishes side by side with an older scientist. While the need of the nation's industrial laboratories for trained personnel is tremendous, it is not quite so desperate that they've had to enlist 13-year-olds. The lad who is learning how bacteria is cultivated is a participant in the Science for Youth program, operated by the DX Sunray subsidiary of Sunray Mid-Continent Oil Company. Twice a month, high school students who are children of employees are given the run of the company's lab facilities to conduct, under supervision, scientific projects of their own choosing. This young lady draws and identifies bacteria she has studied under the microscope. Nearby, in a joint project, two boys wearing protective masks perform an experiment with hydrochloric acid and iron and copper filings. Projects underway run the gamut of the sciences: chemistry, physics, bacteriology, geology, metallurgy, and the rest. The purpose of the Science for Youth program is to encourage high school youngsters to begin thinking seriously about going into the scientific and technical professions, which are sadly short of recruits today and likely to become even more so in the years ahead unless there are more programs like this one to arouse the interest of our young people. Instructors and supervisors for the program are company scientists who volunteer their services 2 evenings a month. Here they discuss plans for the coming year. Originator of the Science for Youth idea was J.V. Lawson, head of the research laboratory, for whom it was a combination of two big interests, youth work and science. There's a minimum of lecturing involved. To as great a degree as possible, the program consists of letting the youngsters develop their own projects, like this one, being shown to the class by one of several boys who took part in it. It's a three-dimensional replica of an oil field, complete even to underground strata and scale model derricks on the surface. Returning to our 13-year-old bacteriologist, we find him on the verge of a great discovery. The discovery that he can grow a colony of living things too small for the unaided eye to see. He's learning, as he counts the microbes, some of the endless fascinations to be experienced by those who pursue a career in science.